Hello, everybody. I'm Will Reed.
And I'm Langdon Reed.
And we are Wilson Fairchild.
That's pretty good. You did that with gusto there, wasn't it?
I'm trying.
Yeah,
I'm trying.
Good. We're back in the blue room. Great to see y'all here again with us. And I don't know what you're doing. Is this some kind of yoga move or what are you
doing? No, I'm working on a trick. Do you like magic tricks?
Well, who doesn't love magic tricks?
Yeah, I'm working on my...
You do magic?
I'm working on it. I'm practicing.
Working on it.
Yeah, I'm trying to. You ever played hide the paper ball?
Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, I'm playing hide the paper ball.
What do you got? Show us. I don't know what.
Well,
like a
you
trick
gotta
ball
start,
or something.
Oh, come on, give me my trick ball.
Here you go.
All right,
it's a trick paper, isn't it?
Well, it looks like a paper ball, but it's a magic trick ball.
Really?
Like that? Yeah. But you know, you gotta watch it.
I'm watching.
Right, look,
it.
You watch it, right? Hand, okay, what hand's it in? It gets sped up, you know, like this, right? Huh? You know, right?
Right.
What hand's it in? You don't know, right?
I don't know.
Okay, all right. Now, what hand's it in?
It's not in either hand. You just
threw it. No, it is. Come on.
You just threw it over your shoulder.
Huh?
You just threw it.
No, it didn't.
Trying to distract me.
No,
I just threw it.
No, I didn't.
It's not in either hand. Open them up. It's not...
It disappeared.
It's over there on the floor.
You saw me?
Yeah.
Dang on it. Okay. You got it.
That's a horrible magic trick.
Well, I'm trying. I was trying to distract you while I threw it. But
yeah.
You saw it?
You need to practice more.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It takes a lot of work.
Do you know
about magic?
Do you know about magic?
Yeah, of course I know about magic.
Well, what do you mean, of course you know about magic?
I've done magic a lot of times. I used to work at the Magic Castle out in California.
You're joking.
For about 14 years.
Yeah. That's where you were.
Started when I was 6 years old.
I knew he was gone for 14 years. I just didn't know where he went.
Yep.
So the Magic Castle?
Oh, yeah. That's some of the
best. Do a trick.
Stuff. I mean,
Do you remember any?
Well, of course I remember some.
All right,
do a
trick.
You like card tricks?
Yeah.
There's a fresh deck of cards right here.
Okay. Do you know David Copperfield?
The magician or the book?
Yeah.
Him too?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. There's a fresh... Yeah.
Okay.
I used to... He and I used to bunk together out there.
Really?
San Diego.
He's got great hair.
He really does.
Yeah.
This is just a regular deck of cards. I just took them out of there.
Right.
You can see that, you know, can you vouch for that everything is on the up and up here, you know?
Very nice deck of cards.
It is, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
So what I'm going to do is just kind of fan these out, right?
Fan them out.
And then I won't even look. It's the whole thing. If you just pick a card, any card you want, they're all face down.
Okay.
I can't see.
Don't look.
My eyes are closed.
Okay, don't look.
So, you know what it is?
I got one.
Show them. I got my head down.
You sure it's okay to show them?
My eyes, get it close so they know that there's no trickery going. There's no tomfoolery.
That's our card right there.
This is straight up magic.
Okay. All right, I got it.
Okay.
Okay, now what?
You take the deck. Yeah, I'm out of it.
I get to touch
it? My sleeves are rolled up. You're touching it from here on out.
Now what?
Put the card back in the deck.
I get to?
Yep. I'm still not looking.
Don't look. Okay, I got it in there.
Because some people know exactly where you put it, and they can... You know,
I get it in there.
Cards.
Okay, I got it.
Is it in there?
Uh-huh.
All right. Now, you shuffle them.
Me?
Yeah, shuffle the cards.
Well, how are you ever going to figure out what card it was?
It's magic.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. And then a little bit more shuffly.
More?
Yeah, shuffly. Okay. All right, buddy. Now, what are you going to do?
I'll find your card in here.
Really?
Yeah. You did put it in here, right?
There's no way.
Yeah.
This is craziness. Craziness.
No, it's not it. Yep. It's not in there.
No, it wasn't.
I made it disappear.
Hmm?
You put the you put the card in the deck.
Yes.
And now I made it disappear.
Okay.
So look under your hat.
Hmm?
Look under your hat.
What?
Look under your hat.
My hat?
Yes. What was that? Show them. It's magic.
How'd you do that?
That's how you do it.
How did you do that? You weren't joking about the Magic Castle?
David Copperfield showed me that thing. Show me how to do it.
I'm a little freaked out.
Bet you are. How about a little song about some cards?
Okay.
That work?
Yeah.
On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, met up with the gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring out the window at the darkness till the boredom overtook us and he began to speak. He said, son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces and knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind me saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice. So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bummed a cigarette and asked me for a light. And the night got deathly quiet, and his face lost all expression. He said, you're gonna play the game, boy. You gotta learn to play it right. You gotta know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done.
David Copperfield.
Every gambler knows that the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away and knowing what to keep. Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser, and the best that you can hope for is to die in your sleep. When he finished speaking, he turned back toward the window, crushed out his cigarette and faded off to sleep. And somewhere in the darkness, the gambler, he broke even. But in his final words, I found an ace that I could keep. You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold 'em,
when to hold 'em,
know when to fold 'em,
when to fold 'em,
know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money.
One, two, three.
When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough for counting.
One, two, three.
When the dealing's done, you got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done.
How did you do that trick?
Magic.
Magic Castle?
Magic.
How'd you put it in my
magic
hat?
Magic.
Hey guys, thanks so much for being in the Blue Room with us. It's always so much fun. And if you like this, you got to check out some friends of ours over on their YouTube channel, Summer and Bray.
Yeah, just click the button. Click the button of Summer and Bray. Summer and Bray on that YouTube channel.
It's easy. Click, subscribe, and enjoy.
Can they understand what I'm saying?
I think so.
Summer and Bray.
Got it. And also stay tuned to our YouTube channel for weekly updates and videos.